there are a lot of things about the universe that I find it almost impossible to imagine. One's just the size and scale of it. I mean, in the piece of the universe we can see, there are something like 2 trillion galaxies. We haven't counted them all, but that's an estimate based on surveys of the local universe.
Imagine standing on the edge of an infinite abyss where the enormous expanse of space stretches before you, far beyond the mind's comprehension. This is not the narrative of a sci-fi film. It is the reality of our universe. From the familiar twinkling stars above to the unfathomable areas beyond our galaxy, we'll explore the depths of space to comprehend the full enormity of the universe. Why waste time thinking about how big the universe is when so much is happening in our little worlds? But looking into the world's secrets isn't just a way to get information, it's also a way to find out who you are. It's not some faraway, vague idea the universe reflects who we are. The famous philosopher Alan Watts said that we are the universe going through a spiritual crisis and can see life's secrets through us. The point is to show you the incredible size of the universe and the lessons it can teach us about our place in it. Even if you think the universe is vast, it will be much bigger than you thought. Are you ready to be amazed? The visible universe alone spans over 93 billion light years, which is a huge and unfathomable number. Starting with Earth, where we usually live, which is bigger than most people think. The fact that it would take more than 17 days to drive around the Earth at 60 miles per hour shows how huge it is. Earth's closest neighbor in space is the Moon, 238,855 miles away. But even this space doesn't seem like much when you consider how big the universe is. To give you an idea of how new space adventure is for people, a car could go 60 miles per hour for 6 months straight. As we go deeper into the solar system, the huge distances become clearer. When you enlarge a picture of the planets in the solar system, they appear as tiny dots in space, which shows how big their areas really are. Earth is 93 million miles away from the Sun, which is the same amount a car would travel in 177 years. 1 million Earths could fit inside the Sun. To give you an idea of how big our solar system is, it would take 5,000 years for a car to get to Neptune. Think of the solar system as a football field that has been shrunk down. In this picture, the Sun, which is barely an inch across, is on top of the goal line. The planets, which are shown as tiny dots spread out across the field, show how far away and empty our cosmic neighborhood is. There is an unquenchable thirst for travel in our species, even though the nearest stars are very far away.
So when people say to me, you want to go into space and because somebody's got some orbital torus thing, and I'm thinking, to me, space is the large-scale structure of the universe. Thank you. Not boldly going where hundreds have gone before, driving around the block.
As long as humans want to learn more about the universe and connect with its people, spacecraft like Voyager 1, which has been in orbit since 1977 and is currently the farthest artificial object from Earth, will keep going around and around it. As our journey through space continues, you may be curious about how far away our solar system really is. The limit has been set by different experts in different ways, which makes this a complicated subject. Some people think that the 5.6 billion mile wide circle of Neptune is the edge. Other possible places are the heliosphere and Pluto's path. There's also the strange Oort cloud, which you can see as a giant orange ball. A very long way from Neptune, this faraway cloud comprises billions of icy comets and is the farthest point of the Sun's gravitational pull. Scales can change a lot based on how a debate about the edge of the solar system turns out. Using Neptune as a reference, it takes around 4 hours for solar light to traverse the specified line. The solar system is almost 3,000 times bigger than Neptune's orbit, but if we use the Oort cloud as the outermost point, that trip lasts for about 15 months. We can find our way around more easily if we use Neptune as a guide. A light year is how far light travels in a whole year. It helps us imagine the huge size of space without getting too caught up in numbers. Light travels at 186,000 miles per second, which makes even the Moon, which is 1.3 seconds away, seem close. Neptune is 4 hours away at the speed of light from this spot, while the Sun is only 8 minutes away. The fact that humans have only recently started to study the solar system shows how big it is. When viewed in comparison to the Milky Way, our solar system seems very small. Proxima Centauri is about 4.2 light years away, which is 25 trillion miles. It is the nearest star to Earth. If you put our solar system on a quarter scale, it would take 4,450 of these systems lined up end to end to reach Proxima Centauri. Based on this size, that star is 350 feet away. Given the huge distances involved, the speed at which we are currently traveling through space means that reaching even our nearest neighboring star will be a job for many, many years from now. Sirius, the biggest star at night, is only 8.6 light years from Earth. It's the beginning of a journey through space to get to know our neighborhood stars. Within 16 light years of Earth, there are 52 star systems, but not all of them can be seen with the naked eye because they are so weak. Even though it is 645 light years away, the huge Betelgeuse can be seen. Its width is 1,000 times that of the Sun. With the way we move now, it would take us about 1 million years to cross this very large interstellar area, which is about 50 light years wide, even at Voyager speed. We reach the radiosphere just past that point. This is a sphere that holds all human signals from World War II onward, marking the start of our species as a radio beacon. There are thousands of stars inside this 160 light year diameter bubble. The biggest ones light it up. This picture is based on real astronomy data and uses tools like the Digital Universe program OpenSpace. It gives curious visitors a way to start learning about the universe. As our view grows to 1,000 light years away, which is a very small part of the Milky Way's width, we can see how big our galaxy is. The Milky Way is so big that it's hard to imagine it has at least 100 billion stars. It's not always easy to understand big numbers. For example, it would take 32 years to count to 1 billion. But when you look at the universe as a whole, even a billion stars are a very small part of the total number of stars in our galaxy. To get an idea of how big these numbers are, think of 100 stars, then 10,000 stars, and finally 1 million stars. A billion, on the other hand, is a lot bigger than these numbers, showing how many stars there are in our sky. As proof of how big the universe is, the fact that the Milky Way has about 400 billion stars is amazing.
And each galaxy is, let's say, around the size of the Milky Way. Some are bigger, some are smaller, but the Milky Way has 400 billion stars in it. It takes light over 100,000 years to cross a galaxy, and there are 2 trillion of them in the piece of the universe we can see. And we're very sure that that piece that we can see is a small bit of what may be an infinite universe beyond. We don't know, actually. And I always say, you know, don't get worried about that, because nobody can picture it.
The radiosphere, which is 160 light years across and shows what Earth looks like electromagnetically, is easy to see from this space location. Our mark on the universe is still very small, and there are still a lot of things that can be found, as this reveal shows. Though the Milky Way is made up of hundreds of billions of stars, we can't help but wonder if there are any other worlds out there. In the last few decades, we've learned more about the universe thanks to studying small parts of the Milky Way, which led to the finding that many stars have planets. We are about to make important discoveries that could change the way we think about the world. At the same time, we are starting to understand how big our galaxy is and whether there is life beyond Earth. When we get close to 1,000 light years, which is a very small part of the Milky Way's width, it becomes clear how huge the galaxy is. The Milky Way is a huge system that is hard for humans to understand. For an idea of how big the Milky Way is, our solar system would have to be about the size of a quarter for the Milky Way to span across North America. The next stop on our trip through space is Andromeda, which is 2.5 million light years away and even farther away. When we zoom out to 110 million light years, we find the Virgo supercluster, which comprises millions of galaxies, each with a swirl of planets and stars like our own. Also, as we go back even further, the Laniakea Supercluster, a vast web of galaxies, becomes apparent. This means that billions of planets are in the Milky Way alone, and some might have life on them. Most stars have planets, meaning the universe is full of unbelievable places. But what does our place in this very big world mean? It makes us feel small by showing us how small we are in the grand scheme of things. The universe is too big and complicated for us to fully understand, and what we do know isn't enough. However, this realization sets you free. It tells us to be open to the unknown, enjoy life to the best, follow our hearts, and remember to live in the present. We are the cosmos as a whole. Eckhart Tolle and Neil deGrasse Tyson have said that we are the world, not just people who live in it. Every atom in our bodies came from stars that burst a long time ago. This is how we are linked to everything else in the universe. This strong connection makes us feel like we are one with everything in the world, and with each other in particular. Carl Sagan said it so well, the universe can learn about itself through us. By recognizing that we all come from the same place and will end up in the same place, we are obligated to treat all living things with kindness, giving, and love. In this way, we honor the universe from which we came. So that is all the time we had today, folks. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon on your way out. See you all next time.